I stream daily, almost daily, on twitch.tv/canister_mtg, so be sure to visit that if you would like to catch some of my live content.
Is that Bartek from Twitch chat? Yes. Bartek from Twitch chat and even Bartek from twitch.tv. Occasionally. Don't watch other streamers though. Canister is all you need. Mr. Brennan for 2 minutes. That's really sad. Did you play 4 fire spots in it? If you managed to get there.
He's a phenomenal control player.
Apod rules, thank you very much for your prime sub.
He's a phenomenal control player.
Colon D indeed. Holy crap, Bosejo is so strong. Ooh, that's a great draw. Probably this way it's better against Fire Eyes, because it's better if I draw an amulet and it's better against Fire Eyes. Because I can draw an untapped land and still cast the One Ring. Explore is better. Yeah, I think it was better in this. Scenario. Because it drew a card. So Azusa would stick in play, but with no amulet, you just run out of lands immediately. Activate it in a way that makes binding inconvenient. Okay. Likely instead of pacting, I'll Bosedru and Dryad next turn. Especially if I draw a bounce land. Is Bartek a creativity gamer? It might be creativity or it might be Rhinos. Both of those being a mountain might imply creativity. Against creativity, we play a Titan, I guess. Against Rhinos, we Bosedru and Dryad. Although, if Bartek keeps up Yellow Remand, then we have to reconsider. Seems like creativity, given that it's a third mountain fetch and it's another mountain fetched. Bounce Grazer. So you bounce Grazer to... Again, you probably would be better off plastic, but I guess instant speed creativity again comes up. It's so that Archon sacrifices the Titan. Also, doing the Leyland Binding seems a bit bad in this situation. Gives my opponent creativity x2. What we can do is I can Titan and get Kremlin Vestige bounce land. To put the Grazer into play to punish Bartek for the bounce. So if Archon enters, I can pay for Pact and have 6 mana for under Titan or play the Dryad. Scrabbles, like, it doesn't matter what I do, I just win. I guess I just, like, discard Bosedru, then I play Dryad, attack, fetch 2 Valak with Steel 18. Because villain needs to tap out to creativity. (Clears throat) Explore is so good. Canister wins, how curious. Now, post combat, I could play Barrow Downs versus the Renlock, but it's not, it doesn't even matter. It's just got two grazer for two explore. I think that's all I want to do against creativity, and we'll see how my opponent will tackle the matchup. If they're gonna have any alternative monsters present in the sideboard. Perhaps. Song reminds you of Tony Hawk games. This one. That's not how my Tony Hawk games sounded like. Isn't Grazer better for the Archon Sack? Most games don't come down to that. Explore drawing a card while ramping is better when facing interaction. When I have to fight through counter magic and bindings, all of that, and Grazer is going down a card while Explore doesn't. Also, oftentimes creativity will shift their creativity target post board to something else, and like this hand, I'm happy to have Explorers in there. Although, I guess Grazer, you know, lets me cast Eternaturing, so that's good too. But if anything happens to my amulet, much happier to have two Explorers and two of those. If I force a steam vent, that's kind of worth something in its own zone. My hand is gonna be a bit weak to pierce, nonetheless. Is Yellow Remand and Tith ever enough for grid? It's pretty inconsistent, like, the amounts of Yellow Remands they run. So I don't think so, and creativity beats grid, so it's not like you have time to chill and deploy stuff like that. It's actually costly to spend mana on this type of effects, so I think it's actually pretty bad. I guess I'm weak to Teferi. Maybe I should have bounced Saga. I'm really weak to Teferi now. I mean, I cast Explore, so it's not that bad, but bit bad. Yellow question mark. Yellow Remand is, yes. There is no strong indication that a spell pierce is present in my opponent's hand, so I think it's a good turn to just play the ring. There was a spell pierce, number two, which is a little bit unfortunate, but the explore will pay off if I draw a bounce land. Not bounce land, an amulet. Or even if I draw gardens, I can go explore, gardens, copy, bounce land, grazer, bounce land, colossus. With two lands in hand at least, maybe three. And double amulet, so that is a relevant line. Might also get my amulet consumed. Might also get creativity. So also going back to greed against remand, Yellow Remained and Mana Tithe. Soft counter magic is counter magic you can play through anyways. Greed is like mostly necessary against the counter magic where you can't play through it. When subtlety or counter spell, you just like can't wait around those. White Remain, you can just recast your crucial thing. How deep was Dish Pizza in Chicago? Pretty deep. It's pretty darn deep. Why are you tapping mana? Cracking a clue? That's odd. Why do you draw in response to that? Curious. Surveilled with the red black and kept a card on top, wanted to draw it. Makes sense. That's a reasonable explanation of the situation. Nonetheless, that means we win. Holy shit, Amulet is so good. It's only turn 4. Cast the One Ring, get it answered. We had an Amulet answered and we win. Melodia. Osage is the real problem. Bro, what's a problem? Like, there's no problem. It's like you're the only one with a problem here. That said, Sedra is really strong, so. Trying to think back and imagine playing the Amulet Titan deck without the One Ring and Bosedru. Rough times. Was a much worse deck back then. Last seen deck 1 day ago, Hammer Time. Holy shit. Thoughts on the new Alchemy cards? I love them. Did I see them or just love them? No, I just love them. It's only singing the chorus. Clients, Esper Sentinel, holy shit, bro. Well, I better draw something. You get to cast Explore though. I think your hand is lacking green mana. A bounce on specifically. Green mana alone wouldn't interest me. Bounce and on top of deck. Arguably, maybe I should fetch two monsters from my deck with Sounders Pact. Is there a card I can draw that will make me survive without comboing off this turn? Crowning Vestige would let me play a Dryad and survive. Otherwise, like, I die if I draw a Vestige of this Explore if I have fucked it twice. Besides that, it's just a bounce land. With Hanro Battlements in my hand. I'll have the extra land drop, bounce land, Dryad, bounce land, go to 5, Grazer, put Battlements into play. Combo off. So I'm going to pact for Titan and Grazer. Draw a Seeming Grove Chamber. And die. Because I hadn't. We did draw a Titan anyway, so I mean, I guess irrelevant that I fetched because I didn't fetch out the Titan that would have been on top of my deck. But instead a random one. Can check my opponent's cyborg strategy by looking up their previous list. We have silence. Seems like not much though. Oh wow, Cryptic Code. 6 planes Cryptic Code. That seems a bit odd. Seems like way too many planes. Like there is what, 5 blue sources? 8 plus this. Holy shit. 6 planes. So I'll just submit. I like to play first. Yes. Let's keep this hand because it seems pretty good if I ever draw a bounce land. And if not, we can map for a bounce land. Explores in the side are for the matches where you want to go fast? Question mark. Incorrect. They're actually for the matchups where I want to go slow. Which might sound like a tongue-in-cheek response, but it is not. It is actually the case. Or rather, in every matchup I want to ramp to make my deck function, but in matchups where it is not of utmost importance to go as fast, I prefer to explore over Grazer when Grazer blocking is not as good. Against Hammer, blocking with Grazer is actually great, so I'll play Grazer instead of not playing it. So I'll just no changes. But if my opponent was playing 4 color and then Grazer would be really bad, then I'd be happy swapping it. Opinion about Leonardo da Vinci block your halfling in game of MTG in near future? It changes everything. Is that a white 3 man situation? Yeah, matches where I want to ramp, but where Grazer being card's advantage, ramp is bad, and I would prefer better ramp. Six, 12. Can cast Titan through white remand. So excuse me, yellow remand. Holy shit, I keep misspeaking. The official name of that card is Yellow Remand. I thought one time. Holy shit. Alright. The Dethroner's Grimoire. The tyrant's bellow of rage trailed off into a whimper as the last of his fortune escaped his grasp. When I say that, I just read out the chat. And Mean Funny Pack just obliged. Love, Saga, No Constructs, Make, Ornithopter. 10-12. I play the onion ring. I play white remand. Excuse me, yellow remand. Not this time. Mana diet. Why are you a non-competitor? I failed to qualify for Pro Tour Seattle, so I'm not competing in Pro Tour Seattle, so I'm a non-competitor for the next one. I guess it is might be not clear from the title. Spending Bosaju on the saga now is good, I think. Doesn't matter much, but I was indeed a competitor at the last one. Villain is going to search up a meticulous archive for giga value. Nope, not this time. I could copy one of my creatures. Mirror Pool enters the battlefield tapped and untaps. Once again, which lets me source a colorless mana, but I will choose to hold up Otawar instead, seems preferable by a good amount. I mean, the mirror pool producing its own colorless mana is a pretty crucial part of the of how it produces. Is it cryptic code? Holy shit, it's cryptic code. Oh wow, it equips to the ornithopter to make it unblockable. That's cool. I haven't thought about the implications of Crypting Code and Sigarda's Aid. The Otawara, the Ornithopter, I guess that should be pretty good. Should work pretty well around silence. Pioneer Hammer build attack then. If Cryptic Code is a standalone Pioneer card, then perhaps, which allegedly is pretty solid in Phoenix's sideboard. First face down creature cast this game on the battlefield this game. I've been asked by Mr. Ducktape where do I find endurance to play this click intensive deck on Modo, and I say, and I forgot to respond to that, but I'll tell you now, I don't know, I just enjoy it, so doesn't feel click intensive to me, it feels just enjoyable, just feels good. This I keep, put back packed. Yeah, it's just Colossus. Colossus is a bit tiresome to resolve sometimes, indeed. Sounds really bad to get my Grazer mana thieved. And little upside to play it on turn one. I mana thieve your Grazer. Okay. I got Colossus in Momir Vig once. How many lands did you put into play? I guess you just like put 15 lands into play, or like 20, and then you just cast Emrakul's every turn. That sounds pretty good. Well, I guess one Emrakul is good enough, the other one is legendary. Or maybe is there a different creature card that costs 15? Autochthon Worm, is that 15 mana? Draka is 16. Okay, so you can get Emrakul, Shadow of Mortality, Autochthon Worm, or Earthquake Dragon. 10-10 Flying Trample, 9-14 Trample, a 7-7, and an Emrakul. Okay. Refetch, Kaldra Complete. Since I have two rings, I'll get tithed now. Is that silence? Alright. What a weird. Like, they decided to cast it in response to this? I mean, I guess then that's like communicates that I'm gonna ring pretty significantly. But like that means I get to cast the ring and protect myself now. So who's really winning here? Five mana. March on my ring? Holy shit. If I draw an amulet, I think I'll just win. Not an amulet, but cast Onion Ring, Duro, draw Tawara, play Saga, fetch Poseju. So next turn I have Tawara plus Poseju. So I shouldn't die. Like they have one card and I'm pretty far away from dying, and then once Saga pops I just pop off on them too. Or I can draw an amulet. I guess if I like, if I did top deck Tithe now or Silence, I should have packed it in response to play the Grazer before Silence resolves. So I get Silence now, I also die. And if I get Tithe on Grazer, I die too. Okay, I didn't. Skill. Bang Razor? Razor barely knew her. Holy shit. I tried playing Fortnite some time ago and I learned that I'm terrible at dexterity requiring tasks. The game we played was called Balatro. It's been recommended to me as a poker-based roguelike. I enjoy both of those, I think. So, sounded like might be pretty cool. Well, to an extent, I guess. I enjoy roguelikes more so than I enjoy poker. And we were cruising through the tutorial as I was eating. Oliphant. I only knew I would have discarded this Cultivator Colossus Ooze, but I've been fooled. Actually, no, I was on the play, so I wouldn't have discarded it. Mane Gwail. Discard a whale. Lucky. Bounce land, bounce land, bounce land, bounce land. Hey, what do you think about the PT topic about Tobias and his flamming? First message. Should we respond, chat? Think Tobias tends to be slightly cringe at times. And that was one of those times. Time to die to Violet Outburst. EOT. Seven, seven, eight, 15, 23. Yep. Do I ever have to interact with the other Haruya gamers? Not really, but Mark hasn't been a Haruya pro for a while. Well, I think his profile picture is in the Haruya shirt, which might make you confused. Am I a 60 card truffer or a 61 gamer? I just board up to a bigger deck. There is no point in having a 61 card deck, main deck. If you like think through how can you build your deck, it's just worse to go up on cards. Shining happy people. This is good against grief. And I can turn free. I mean, is it good against grief? They did grief the dryad. And I can turn free pass. Not anymore. It's kinda good against grief. Just take the dryad. Probably shouldn't have kept it. So I was just straight up there to play Gruul Turb, right? Turn one, turn two. Anyone breeding in a pool? We get to either play the one ring or have Dryad in play. Resolves, that's nice. Shiny, happy people. Holy schnacks, the thundering falls away an island? No, they kept the card on top. How did the island end up there? It was from the hedge maze. Hedge maze. Oh yeah, the technique of hedging. 17 power on their graveyard. Seems weak if they agent, seems manageable if they outburst. Nice. Really rocks. I mean, I say nice as a sound 20 power, but you know. Oh, they didn't even discard. Didn't have Force of Negation for the last one. Even in their sleep. Even in their sleep. Holy shit, to be a cowboy. I mean, it's not a matter of opinion, Hogobi. It's just pretty clear. 18 more in the yard, right? That's what he says. Wild Cowboys out in the yard. Well, maybe it's just 36 Cowboys. If I play Titan and get subbed, that's bad for me, to me. I'm at 16, I take 10, 12, 15. I think I'll go Greed, Dryad, Explore. Because I only get to shoot twice, so I shoot Grief and Agent. Shoot the curator, block the agent, die to outburst, jump the end, pact resolve Mr. Beast. I think sub is in the range of things they could do. Outburst didn't seem like it was in their hand because they sorcery speed living ended, which seemed bad. Will likely not need to charm the end. Eighteen more in the yard. That is not useless. With this I should be able to charm the end. Bouncing procedure is just better, I guess. Whatever. That's fine too. Cowboys getting fucked even in their sleep. The issue is that an untapped land pass means they can still sub. Bit of an issue. Through double greed. Holy shit, 3 spells even when taxed with extra 6 mana still very strong. It's a bit rough to champ. Still. Having to pay for the pact. I draw 4 new cards in my draw step. But playing a Titan with a single amulet would mean I get to Otawara a curator. It's not necessarily great, but if I draw 4, I'll probably figure something out. A second amulet is likely. They can't hold up interaction on my turn, so let's play around the outburst. So I should draw either a new ring or... or something. Drawing the one ring even in my sleep. Hello, Canister. How are you today? Pretty good. Thank you for asking. Woke up at a reasonable hour, jet lag didn't exist anymore, and sat down to play a modern prelim with my favorite deck, so life's good. I keep the other ring, I draw a few more cards, so maybe it's better, but likely irrelevant. Oh no! Cracking the food tokens. Opponent is in the game. Thanks to the extra 6 life gained with Generous Ends. I say as if that is literally not the play I'm going to make next turn. Why not attack here? Was there anything that could mess you up? Otawara? Could mess me up. So no reason to attack because if I untap I'll win. Like really hard, right? I guess Otawara on Amulet would also mess my the One Ring, so maybe I shouldn't have played a Titan at all, just cast the One Ring, arguably. Six mana sub incoming. Wait, I actually don't kill them. Because they have so much toughness. They have 14 plus 4, 18, 41. So I don't deal 41 damage, I'm pretty sure. Although, let's count. 3 Titans attacking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 6. So there's 3 more bounce lands in my deck. Pack Dryad. It's the third Dryad in my deck still. Mr. Beast should be Tamagotchi. 2 Simigrove Chambers. Mr. Beast can be summoned, yeah. Plus combat 2, so that's also good. Alright, let's not count anymore. We can also get Mirror Pool. Grove Chamber, copy. Grove Chamber, Gruul Tour. Doesn't matter. They're at minus 10. What do you mean? They're at 23. But let's count how much damage do I make with the Titans if I attack, just out of curiosity. Copy Titan, haste 2 new Titans, no mana, attack, fetch, bounce bounce, Vesuva, no, bounce, Kremlin Vestige Gardens, copy, amulet, bounce on bounce land, Turf, Kessig, 6, 6, 6, 18, 20, 21, 22, minus 3, 19, plus 18, that is 37, and they have 41. Alright, so that's, I don't like. So let's just get Dryads. Oh yeah, last pack too. Great block by villain. Always he has option working. I think they fixed it somehow. Which is incredible. Yeah, let's reset model. That sounds good. Which matchups are the Storms, Refs, 4? This, this, this. Merktide to an extent. But specifically, mostly Rhinos. It's at its best against Rhinos, so it's like I'm playing the sweeper that matches up the best against Rhinos, and I'm suffering through it being slightly worse than Fire Spout against the other decks. Will I play standard? Maybe a little bit, but don't expect it too much during the daily streams. I am planning on qualifying for the RC by, I don't know if I should keep this. It's all in on the ring. I'm planning on qualifying for Napoli by doing well in Prague. So I'm skipping Free City. Napoli is the standard RC. If I mulligan, there's a chance Pojuka Bog will show up in my hand. Double ring. This is not a good hand, but ring is so good against Living End, I'll keep it. Maybe I can top deck Pojuka Bog in my first draw step or spend 2 turns discarding a Titan. We'll skip the last round again to scrap out of a MTGO challenge again. Bro, I did not scrap out of a MTGO challenge. I played the showcase qualifier in Vintage and I missed on top 8ing it, but it was, I mean, pretty close. It's just that Will doesn't know what's a challenge and what's not a challenge, so he just said the incorrect thing. So Will was saying, haha, Callister is playing a Vintage challenge instead of that, but I wouldn't drop out of Prague to play a Vintage challenge. But like a Vintage Showcase qualifier is a very high value event to play in. Generous end. Alright, let me draw a Pojuka Bog, please. One time, Bogers. Bog champ. Sub into the graveyard. Holy shit. All right. We get our own end. Holy shit, grief here is devastating. Because I have 2 rings to discard too. Not so good. Ori pitch. Rafe. Oh, opponent puts roughly 10,000 power in play. Six, 11, 19. 28, 30, I count 31 power. Draw step, when I draw a Sroseju. I think I do live though. Unless my opponent has force for ring, I guess then I don't, but Yeah, but like if they don't take the ring and they have force for it, it's like I cast it, they force it, then they win. That's what I meant. They might have sub for this too. Which I think kills me. Sub on sub. So if this blocks 7 damage, gains 3. So I have 30 and you counted 31, so that's death. It would be super risky to wait for Joseph if they didn't have sub, because you could draw Endurance there. But Living End players are known for risking it for the biscuit. So I block here and I take 12. And 12. So yeah, it's exactly lethal. I could block one more damage by blocking the Waker and be exactly dead. They had subtlety, so it wasn't a risk necessarily. If you read the message right above yours, it says exactly that. 2 days ago, Amulet Titan. Holy shit, can't wait to Mulligan to 4 and die. Because that's all you do in the mirror. And you are. Honestly, that's what I thought. I appeared all. Point cap 7. Three is pretty brutal. My hand was a good 7, but it's probably not the highest win rate 3, you could imagine. It's probably one of the best draws though. Two amulet. Played out a Boseju. Probably just I don't know, map for what? Nothing to map for. That changes anything particularly. So I'll just peacefully get an amulet and die next turn. Cruel Turf has entered the battlefield, so I do wonder if I mull a bit too aggressively in the mirror match, but I would have lost if I hadn't mulliganed too, so I think I don't, right? Perhaps I'll keep this. I mulligan to 6. Not the best hand, it goes okay if I get to copy Saga. Not really, my opponent's Saga pops first, but I mean, mulling to a too low of a hand is also pretty bad, and going turn to Gruul Turf Explore replay Otowara is not the worst. Holy shit. Maybe I get to bounce to the Saga. I gain access to blue mana. I can Titan next turn, but I have to pay for two pacts. 4-8 mana total, dead to Boseju if I do that. That's a blue mana source for the Saga, but my opponent likely deploying a Dryad, probably bouncing the Growth Chamber to begin with, so I guess not even that. Play Bossaggio. Xiv Gardens is a strong top deck, right? Not quite. I am short on... I think I'm missing an Azusa here in this spot. I could go fetch Azusa, play Otawara, Vezuva, bounce back Otawara, and I have 3 mana to spend it on Otawara's channel. I think the like biggest... The one situation where Azusa is actually relevant is when you have an option to utilize the channel land discount. Then she effectively nets an extra mana. Gardens, Grazer, that leaves me with 5 mana, so I cannot Titan. Bounce land, Pact for Grazer, bounce land. Given the heavy Bossaggio in play, I cannot go with that line. What I can do to survive is I could Pact for Grazer, play Grazer, put Otawara into play, Vezuva, copy Turf, bounce back Otawara. But it does leave me without outs to win, I think, because I'll have to trade bounce land, that's gonna be really bad. Titan, keep up Bossaggio, destroy their bounce and pray for no second bounce. It loses to Stomping Ground, being in their deck. I kind of congrats and well played for winning the challenge, thanks. Stomping Ground and second tapped land. No, Stomping Ground, they bounce their Bossaggio and they keep destroying my land with Bossaggio, I die to that. And also, they don't even need a Stomping Ground because it loses to Forest in their deck too, because they Forest, then they have 2 mana, bounce the Bossaggio, Bossaggio one of my lands, I don't have 8 to pay. So I think if I summon a Titan this turn, I kill myself, which I don't like the idea of. Do we respect Fov? I mean, like, I can't beat no Fov, so I don't care for Fov. Am I happy with the winning list or I would change something? I'm playing with a slightly different list today, so I guess I would. And I did. But it's minor changes and mostly the same. I have explorers in my sideboard today. Would be so much easier if Gruul Turf was a Growth Chamber, but we drew the incorrect one. I would just play Gardens, bounce the Saga, win next turn. Holy shit, that's so inconvenient. So like the Grazer line just leaves me with nothing, right? Because I have to keep 5 mana in play, not to die to Bossaggio after pacting. So there is a chance I don't have a Titan in hand. It does seem kind of like that is my best bet. That they don't have a Titan in hand, I don't die next turn. Villain is on 3 cards with Growth Chamber revealed. Maybe they'll respect my own Bossaggio, but like, I mean, they'll just cast a Titan, there's nothing to respect. But going through all the lines and eliminating the ones that kill me on the spot against known information, I can't find anything that is better than just hoping that they don't have a Titan. So I'll pass and die next turn to the Titan that they obviously have in their hand because... How could they not? Yeah, I play Seeming Growth Chamber. Maybe it's just Ring. I think it's just Ring. Dryads. Playing second right for the Lulz. Play ring. Damn. Still only have one card in hand now, so there is hope. Well, that does not look very hopeful. Might be TOS Transmutation 2. Or Mr. Beast with one land into Droic Razor. Mop. Okay, mop. Mop for what? For TOS? US for Pact, but you don't have any extra land drops, I don't think so. Holy shit, we survived, and somehow they kept the Vasedju in play. I mean, makes sense, although with the One Ring, not so sure. It gave me a sweat, but we live. A meat sweat. No clock. I mean, yeah, I guess they have the ring protection, so I technically have to like count for that. I'm gonna do the copy Colossus in your unkeep line. Ideally. Holy shit. All right, game three is gonna be rough at this rate. Modo literally became cookie clicker. All right, I can see that. That spared me probably like 3 more minutes of stacking and performing that kill. Bounce 4 lands. Yeah, 5 lands in hand. I have to like Titan for mirror pool too. But yeah, the amount of time I spent on that previous turn thinking was pretty damaging in this spot, so should have be faster. Should have been faster. No amulet by Mulligan's to 6. Well, I'll Mulligan the sand too because it's bad. This goes Amulet, has Boseju, goes explore, explore. It's not great, but seems worth keeping. Point goes Saga. Baron Downs is Pojuka Bog. Play out a grazer to put a second play. That seems odd. I don't think that's a line that should be taken off then. I draw bounce land, I'll play Titan next turn, otherwise I have Boseju this turn, Boseju next turn. Well, I guess I can just bounce the bounce land. Yeah. Play Onion Ring, okay. What deck is the opponent on? Well, Amulets. Well, I'm playing Stomping Ground 2, and I think it's actually better than Commercial District in this deck, but. Just imagine that. If it was Scry and not Surveil, I would be happier to play it too because Surveil in a two-door deck always stinky. If I ever survey Hanur battlements, if I ever see Hanur battlements with my commercial district, I'll have to quit the game, so I just prefer not to play it instead. Did Hive Mind Amulet with Serum Vision play temples? One or two at times. I played it for some time. Ben Spokor played it too. Like, you mean Summer Bloom Amulet, right? So I pass with two titans in play and two boss edges, so I think we're good. So best my opponent can do is stall with the ring more. Boss edge XDD. Why are we XDDing at boss edge? Is it because you have became boss edge build, Gab, and you think it's the least balanced card in the set, in the format? When I was 25, I have two Titans. I can Kha'Zix for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Plus 16. 25. 23. Okay, lethal. Even more. Kiss by the Rose. All right, I would have timed out if my opponent made me click through the combo in game two, so I guess I appreciate their pity, the pity they took on me. Because otherwise it would have been a 2-2 prelim and not a 3-1 prelim. We lost to Living End after not drawing hate. I don't know, I kind of feel like, I don't know, free bo like more Bojuka box. That's not so strong. Scavenger grounds, perhaps over the endurance number two. Two Bojukas is the same angle sorcery speed, it's too bad. I
think.